Hello students, today we are going to start class 12 curriculum for political science. We are going to begin with the first chapter. The chapter is challenges of nation building. So let's start the chapter.
Hello students, today we are going to discuss the first chapter of political science curriculum. The first chapter is challenges of nation building. So first we are going to discuss about trust with destiny speech. So let's start. Trust with Destiny was an English speech delivered by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first PM of independent India, to the Indian Constituent Assembly in the Parliament. He gave the speech on the eve of India's independence towards midnight on 14th of August 1947. He spoke on the aspects that transcend India's history. First of all, we are going to discuss about the different goals of nation building. So the first goal regarding nation building was running the country through democratic processes. And the next point was the government will run for good of all. So these are the two important goals of the nation building of India. So let us understand the points. So if we talk about the democratic processes, it includes where people can do whatever they like, but the thing is that they need to follow the norms set by the government. So whenever they are trying to do something, it should not hurt anyone. So this is the basic thing regarding democratic processes. It includes you can choose your own religion, there should be any biasness between caste, gender and creed. And everyone is equal before the law. So these were some of the democratic processes which were adopted by India. So regarding the second point, the government will run for the overall growth of the country. So the main idea regarding the government is for overall development of India. The government is going to take care of the complete population of the country. So as we all know, the people living in a country can be considered as the human resource. So the main idea of nation building came from development of the human resources. Now we are going to discuss about the different challenges of nation building. Okay, so let's start. The first immediate challenge was to shape a nation that was united yet accommodative of the diversity in our society. Yeah, so as we all know, India is a very vast country, and in India you are going to find people from various religions, caste, creed and gender. So for a country like India to be accommodative is very important. The second challenge was to establish democracy. The challenge was to develop democratic practices in accordance with the constitution. India is one of the largest democracies of the entire world, and to sustain with democracy is not a very easy thing. So this was a very big challenge for the country, India. So now let's discuss about the third challenge. The third challenge was to ensure the development and well-being of the entire society, and not only of some sections. The real challenge was now to evolve effective policies for economic development. Because of the huge amount of populations, so all the sections of the society comprising of different languages, different castes and all different kinds of things needs to be given same amount of respect, and there should be equality between all these different sections. So this was a very important thing, and it was also a very big challenge for the country India. The real challenge, it just says, was to evolve effective policies. So all of us read about the 5-year plans and all, right? Yeah, so if we talk about the 5-year plans, these plans were adopted so that we can like have some effective policies which are going to help us in taking care of our economy and also our society and all these kinds of things. So effective policies are very important, because without having effective policies, we cannot plan out like in which way we're going to use our resources and all. So this were some of the major challenges that was faced during the nation building of India. So now let us discuss about the Muslim League. So Muslim League was always in support of the two nation theory, and because of this we all know our country got divided into two parts. One part became Pakistan and the other part, as you all know, is India. So now let us discuss about the process of partition. So there was no single belt of Muslim majority at that point of time. So Pakistan comprised of two communities. So it included both West and East Pakistan. Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan was known as the Frontier Gandhi. So he was reluctant by the idea of the Muslims joining Pakistan. So he always felt that the people, the Muslim people who wanted to join Pakistan can join, but all the Muslim people should not be forced to join Pakistan. Not all the majority of Muslim people wanted to join Pakistan. The third problem was that two of the Muslim majority provinces of British India, Punjab and Bengal, had very large areas where non-Muslims were in majority. These areas were bifurcated on the basis of religious majority. The minorities faced like big problems as they became undesirable aliens in their own home. Now let's discuss about the consequences of partition. So cities like Lahore, Amritsar, Kolkata became divided into communal zones. The people were forced to abandon their homes. 8 lakh people migrated across borders. In between, 5 to 10 lakh people were killed during the partition. After migration of Muslims, about 12% Muslims were left in India. So these were the basic consequences of partition. So now let's discuss about the integration of princely states. So British India was divided into British Indian provinces and the princely states. If we discuss about the British Indian provinces, so these were directly under the control of the British. And if we talk about the princely states, these princely states enjoyed some form of control over their internal affairs as long as they accepted British supremacy. This was called as paramountcy of the British crown. So this was all about the integration of princely states. So with end of British rule, so there was lapse in paramountcy of the British crown. About 565 princely states became independent and they were free to join any group. The decision was left to the princely rulers. The ruler of Travancore, Nizam of Hyderabad, made a similar announcement. Nawab of Bhopal was averse to joining Constituent Assembly. Yeah, so here we were discussing about the problems of nation building. So if we have talk about the problems of nation building, it started with the end of the British rule, and because of this it led to lapse in paramountcy of the British crown. So about 565 princely states became independent and now they were free to join any of the groups. So they could have joined Pakistan or they could have joined India, and the decision was left to the princely rulers. So the decision was completely on the rulers of the princely states to which group they wanted to join. So the ruler of Travancore and the Nizam of Hyderabad, they made a similar announcement and they were not willing to join India. They wanted to remain independent without joining any of the forces. So this was regarding the problems of nation building. So now let us go through the government's approach towards the process of nation building in India. So Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, who was at that time the Indian Deputy Prime Minister and the Home Minister after independence, played an important role formally but diplomatically to bring the princely states to India. So all of you might know about the Statue of Unity. So Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel is known as the Iron Man of India. He played a major role in bringing the princely states under India. So because of this, as he played an important role in the unification process of India, he is known as the Iron Man of India. So the government's approach was guided by three considerations. Now, so the people of the princely states wanted to be the part of India. The government was flexible in giving autonomy to few regions. The backdrop of partition, which brought into focus the contest over demarcation of territory, the integration and consolidation of the territorial boundaries of the nation, had assumed supreme importance.
Thank you, students. This was all for today's class. So till then, stay at your homes and stay safe.